Introducing the all-new Seiko Sharp Edge Presage SPB227J1, and this one is in beautiful blood moon red. The red sharp is definitely blurring the lines between dress and sports watch, even more than the other Sharp Edge series watches. It has a push-pull signed Seiko crown, which is 7 millimeters, giving 100 meters of water resistance. Match that up with the dye shield coating throughout, sapphire crystal. It's a great recipe for a sports watch, but it can double, as you can tell, as a dress watch, like the old Sarbs. The last Sharp Edge series we reviewed was 11 months ago, and it was the black one, and we compared it to the Sarb. The Sarb prices were a little bit higher back then, so getting a Sharp Edge series might be a little bit less compelling now that the Sarb has come down a bit. However, you're getting a unique new design, which is very handsome. It has tons of presence, and the finishing on the case with the fine brushing on top of those broad, thick lugs, which have faceted tips, high polish on the sides of the case, very nicely done, and high polish bezel. It's a well-finished watch on the outside. Inside could use a little bit of work, dust-wise. I don't know why, but wherever these are made, the Presages always have way more dust than, let's say, a Pro Specs. Of course, you can only see it under extreme macro. Let's do those measurements. 39.3 in diameter. We have a thickness of 11.5. Very thin, but it does wear thicker than that. I don't know why it wears a little bit thicker. Maybe because the cut is so flat and broad. We also have no drilled lugs and a lug to lug of 47 even. All right, so a nice compact dimension, but it wears definitely like a 40, maybe even a 41 because of those flat, broad edges throughout the case. It just has such a demanding presence. Now the bracelet, one of the best bracelets on a relatively affordable Seiko. There is basically no gap here. The fitment is great. Unfortunately, it is male end links. The middle link has high polished flanks. Very well done. High polish on the sides. We have solid end links and solid links, pins and collars, and the clasp has very minimal gap right there. See that? So very flush. I am gonna ding it on only having 2 micro adjusts, but there is a half link on each side, so you should be able to get a nice fit. It is fully milled, and you can see that display case pack with the 6R35. The sapphire is completely flat with AR on the underside. Now the dial and hands, beautiful sword style hands that are divided in the middle, half brushed and half polished. It is a beautiful look, and the way it plays with the light is gorgeous, just like those faceted baton indices. We do have a prominent keystone at 12, date with a black date disc at 3. It integrates nicely and it has that beautiful hemp leaf pattern that Seiko talks about. Textured dial, 3-dimensional, looks fantastic. A little bit of a negative is the applied Seiko logo is on a pedestal. It's on like a landing platform instead of being directly on the dial. I think that would have looked better being directly on the dial. So overall, fantastic case and dial, but again, the finishing on the inside needs to improve. As I was filming it, I did notice more dust than I would like, but guys, really, I've seen worse on Orises, and actually the Air King that I reviewed was worse, which if you guys don't know, Air King is a Rolex. Now the price. This one comes in at 1,000 USD. Of course, you can get a used 033 Sarb if you want to save a bit and you want a little bit more of an elegant feel on the wrist, being at 38 and wearing a lot smaller than this 39. Initially, I thought this could be a great replacement for the Sarb series. However, although I think the case quality is better here, bracelet definitely way better than the Sarbs. Movement, debatable. I think I like the 6R15 better. It wears large, so it completely changes the dynamic. More of a sports watch, Sarb leans towards the dressy side. All right, here it is next to the SKX. And as you can see, 39 versus 42. It's not that big of a difference because of that all dial look and the broad case design. Wow, an eye opener for sure. And the reach is longer on the Presage. So if you have an SKX and you're looking for a sports watch, you know what? Consider the Sharp Edge series if you love the size of 42 and you're worried about the 39, don't be. Okay, here it is on my 6.5-inch wrist, and it wears actually pretty good. So it is a 39, but it has a little bit more presence. That long reach right there still wears nicely. And the ultra thin 11.5 does wonders for this sports watch. Yeah, you know what? It's awesome. The weight with all the links is 151, so very nice. And if you put this on a nice strap, I think it will suit it very well. Okay, we're gonna check her out on the time graph. 6R35, Hack Henwine automatic, 70 hours of power reserve, 24 joules, low beat, 21.6 VPH. And look at these numbers, not bad. Plus 40, 265 amplitude, a little bit low, but not bad for this movement. Little bit of beat air, 0.2. 0.00, yeah, looking pretty good. Decent line, clean, and the fourth and final round, 0. Okay, we're gonna do 12 down now to see the positional variance, how it's gonna react on your wrist. And wow, wait a minute, look at that amplitude, 211. That's dangerously low. What's going on? I know these 6Rs have low amplitude, but it's hard to complain when you see the rate. The beat air actually improved to 0.1, not bad. Plus 1, 0, 0, and the fourth and final round, plus 3. All right, pretty good. Okay, there is the Loomshot, very powerful Seiko Lumabright. It is definitely a sports watch with this loom. Man, very nice, just like the Sarb, but a lot more loom on those sword style blade hands. Very nice. The Red Sharp series is a thing of beauty. I love the Fume effect on the dial. It fades to black. Even the chapter ring, they made the chapter ring a dark burgundy wine red to match that Fume effect. So it's a nice cohesive look. It's a home run, definitely leaning towards the sports watch vibe. Very playful with the red. I don't know if I'd ever own a red watch. I still think the black Sharp Edge series is the one to get, followed by the blue and white as a tied for second. But this one is definitely fun and definitely gorgeous. Let me know your thoughts and opinions down below. And if you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.